Hi, you've probably heard already about scaling. People use the term scaling as a bit of an umbrella kind of term for all the things that we do to your marks from your school assessment and exam results to turn them into a scaled score. In TIS, we talk more about marks adjustment processes because there are actually three things that we'll do to your marks. And why would we do that? Well, it's because we're actually trying to compare the results of people that come to us from a couple of hundred different schools throughout WA, from people doing a broad range of different subjects within those schools. And within those subjects, people are achieving at vastly different levels. And somehow we've got to find a way to compare all of that so that we can calculate your tertiary entrance aggregate and move on to calculate your ATAR. I talked in a previous video about the ATAR that a lot of what we're doing is about comparing your performance this year to the performance of everyone else in WA. The marks adjustment processes take a look very specifically at a couple of different contexts in which you achieve your marks to make sure that you're not advantaged or disadvantaged by those different contexts. There are three contexts that we look at: schools, exams, and courses. And the three processes that we do look at each one of those in turn. So for schools, we have a process called statistical moderation that the School Curriculum and Standards Authority does. Then for different exams, we have a process called standardization to make sure that things are nice and even that way. And then finally, the process called scaling is where we actually look at the context in different courses to make adjustments that way. So firstly, moderation. This is where we actually look at your school marks and make sure that those school marks are fair compared to everybody else's school marks in WA. And why would we do that? Well, you would know sometimes that some teachers might be slightly harder markers than other teachers. And if that happened for someone in year 12 and they had a tough marking teacher compared to one of their friends in another school doing exactly the same subject who had a very easy marking teacher, then the first person could be at a bit of a disadvantage. And so the statistical moderation process that the School Curriculum and Standards Authority does looks at how you've been marked as a group within the school for a particular subject and how that group has performed in that subject in the exam. Because no matter what school you attend in WA, everyone who does a particular subject will sit exactly the same WAIS exam. So that's used to just double check how you've been marked at school and to make sure that there's consistency between your group's school marks and your group's performance in the examination. Once we've done that, then your moderated school marks and your exam marks are combined to form a combined mark for that course. So it's good to remember that 50% of your final mark is actually your school mark. So if you do well throughout the year, not only are you well prepared for the exam, but you actually have 50% of your final mark already sorted out before you head into the exam. So the second process is called standardization. And this is where we just make sure that no one's advantaged or disadvantaged depending on whether they get a tougher exam paper or an easier exam paper at the end of the year. You would know that some tests that you do can be tougher than others. You might have a test that's really fair and easy and everyone feels that they can have a good go at it. Another test just might be really tough, and even the best person in that subject found it a struggle as well. So the standardisation process just looks at how well everyone in the state who's done a particular subject has done in the exam. And it makes sure that at the end of that process, for every subject, we're not looking at schools individually now, we're looking at everyone who's done, say, computer science or English as a whole. We just make sure that the results from those combined scores are fairly even with a similar kind of average and a similar kind of spread of marks. Because remember, we've got to try and add these together at the end. Once we've done that, then the final thing that we do is a process called scaling. People think, oh, scaling is about hard subjects versus easy subjects. It's not about that. It's actually about the level of academic competition within a subject. And we do a sort of scaling process a lot in the sporting field. So say you came third in your school athletic 100-metre final. You could be rightly proud of that. But I wonder if that's a greater or lesser achievement than someone coming, say, third in the Olympic 100-metre final. I think most of us will probably say that the Olympic performance is just a little bit more advanced because the level of competition is so much greater in the Olympics than it is at your school carnival. And so what we do with the scaling process is just look at the level of academic competition within each subject and make sure that you're not disadvantaged because you've been in the midst of other people who are achieving very strongly across the board. Okay, so we'll go into more detail on that in another video for you. Once we've done all of that, we end up with the scaled scores, which can be quite transformed compared to your original marks. Remember that the reason that we're doing all of this is to do with comparison and adding together these results from all these different contexts so that we can form your tertiary entrance aggregate and then form your ATAR from that. At the end of the year, you'll also get another report called the ATAR course report for each of your ATAR subjects. Have a look at that because that gives you a different kind of viewpoint on your performance. It will compare how well you've done in a particular subject against everyone else who's done that subject in WA, but it doesn't then have to worry about comparing that subject to different subjects. So it gives you sort of a more standalone kind of picture of your performance. So just keep that in mind. What we do to your marks is for a specific purpose, and it's affecting everyone in one way or another.